Hello everyone, this is part 6 of my Byzantium game on Civ 5, turn 621. So things are starting to move along nicely here. Where was I sending that guy? Well, clearly I'm not leaving him there. That's, oh, right. Farming. That's what I'm doing. More farming. Okay. So that's going to, get me to a fairly maximal position for food production. Hello?
Yes, hi, my name is Mike. I'm calling you on behalf of Cam Clark, Airdrie. Just wanted to, personally, invite you down for an Ohio pricing sales tonight going on next Wednesday and Thursday. Would you be interested in checking that out?
Not really, and I'm kind of wondering why you're calling from a New Brunswick phone number. Okay, that would explain it. no, I'm not particularly interested, and I wonder if you could put me on a do not call list for the promotions.
Sure, I'll do that for you.
Okay, cool.
All right, thank
you. Bye. Well, that was fun. Stupid telemarketers. Right, and that is pretty much what you need to do to get that sort of thing to stop. Tell them to put you on their do not call list. I'm kind of toying with the idea I'm not going to blank out that bit there. I don't remember what I was doing with that swordsman there. I really don't know what I was doing with him. Usually it's pretty obvious, but apparently not this time. Well, guess I'll just park the swordsman in a city and leave it at that. That might even be what I was planning to do. Continue my farming expeditions over here. And that's the Musicians Guild there. What's the Grand Temple give us? Doubles religious pressure. Sure, why not? It's only going to take 15 turns anyway, and that's pretty fast on a marathon game speed. Right. And Compass is coming up here, and that gives us more trade routes that we don't need in the harbor. The galleys as well. Okay, swordsman's in the city now. What was I doing over here? There's going to be a reasonable number of production tiles in range here. The hills, iron, stone. So yeah, I'll just keep on with the farming there too. What have we got here? Machinery, faster movement on road. That's ironworks. We're not. Somebody else got Alhambra. Somebody else got Notre Dame. I think Notre Dame. I guess. Armory. Astronomy means we can cross ocean. Uh, Well, chivalry gives us knights. I'm gonna go for machinery, so I can put up the ironworks. The goal here is to get a massive production level in Constantinople here. We're up to 54 already, and that's pretty substantial for this stage of the game. This is actually a pretty decent early game this time around here. It didn't look like it was going to be a particularly good start initially, but things managed to play out in a beneficial manner, and that's kind of nice, actually. The only drawback of trade routes is you have to keep re-establishing them. There's a good reason for that, of course. It's simply because if you didn't, then it would be quite difficult to change them later on. You'd have to find some way to do that, and you have to track down the caravan or whatever. So I kind of understand why they've done that. Okay, that's a library. Wild. Yeah, market will be good there. I want to get enough stuff out that I'm generating a good gold return so that when I do build a massive army out, if I do, I don't end up with a big gold deficit. Right. I'm building the science of buildings here. I want to get my science up so that I can get out ahead of everybody, so I can get to the internet texts and stuff ahead of everybody else. With my religion, I'm actually doing pretty good for tourism without having any great works, which is actually quite impressive. Once I get these national wonders out, I'll go ahead and settle some more cities, I think. I need to pick somewhere to plant a great prophet. Well, you know what? I'll just plant him there. And as before, I'm not doing declarations of friendship. It just generates too much diplomatic screen traffic that just gets in the way of everything. I do kind of wish there was a way to turn off great profit generation prior to the industrial era. Especially if you've got good, like turn off automatic great profit generation, especially when you've got good faith generation. You end up with a stack of great profits that you don't actually need, which is a little bit annoying if you want to save up the faith for other things in, say, in the industrial era. I'm losing grasp on Ormus. Ah. Okay. Yeah, it's real easy to get distracted here. I had an ooh shiny moment there. Forgot to end the turn. Ooh, a great artist. Now, there's a couple of things I could do here. I could make a great work, or I could make a golden age. I've got. Okay, I need art from the same era and civilization for the theming bonus on the Sistine Chapel. So actually, what I'm going to do is save that great artist until I get another one. Then I can make two works of art at the same time. And that will get me the theming bonus. Okay, so that's a grand temple. I'll do the National College first because that's science. I'll restore that trade route. And notice it was 18 before, now it's 15, so that's quite the difference. Right. Okay, so Poland has gone and settled a city where I was going to. Oh well. That may mean I end up going to war with Poland to take those cities at some point instead of settling my own. That's fine. I'll probably end up doing that just to knock them back a bit. Although, with Poland going to war, it may not be that big of a deal. So that hill here, that'll be a mine. Now, on the upside, with these cities here, I'm going to get more religious pressure emanating in this direction, combating the stuff coming out of Lisbon here. Down and start working on stuff for Antioch here. Well, that's horses. I might as well improve that. What have I finished here? Okay. So I'll. No, I'm gonna go for the garden. Increase the great people generation is worth doing potentially. I'm not sure if I have anything there that's generating great people, but at some point I probably will. Well, let's take a look. Well, great engineers. Okay, so yeah, it's worth a garden there. So that's machinery. Let's see. I'll go for chivalry now. I don't want to get too far behind on the war techs. Ooh, a great engineer. I might end up actually planting a few of them for manufactories if I get a lot of them. What have I got here? Yeah, again, I'm generating great people there, so I might as well build the garden. I really should put a garden in Constantinople if I don't have one there, too. Well, let's take a look. Purchase. I don't have a garden there yet. At 1320 gold, I could buy one. Finished a market here. You know what? I'm going to put the garden there too. Now, Ormus wants a road, so you know what? I'm going to actually do that. Now, this guy, send him over here. Now, I could farm that, but... it's a hill, so I'll go for a mine for production there. Right. So this would be four road chunks to get to Ormus here. Trade routes. Moving things around within your empire doesn't look like it's a good use of your trade routes, but it does actually make quite a difference. And moving food and production, I don't believe it impacts the production and food and the city you're moving it from, which seems odd. You're manufacturing it out of nowhere, apparently. So let's take a look. Production. Yeah, it doesn't show that any is being lost there, so... Okay, so I finished the National College, so I can go for Ironworks, which is plus 8 production, or Heroic Epic. I'm going to go for Ironworks. And I finished here, I'll put a garden there too, because, yep, I've got great people coming up there. So it's great engineers mostly, which are actually quite useful. Okay, I can start building some units here. I'm going to start building my ranged units for defending cities. So the catapult isn't particularly strong, but it upgrades the trebuchets and so on, and eventually to rocket artillery, which is what I'm aiming for. And over here, I've got a barbarian to take care of. Right. Got here. Well, that's a decent tile on a tundra. A pikeman. Three more road pieces for that road to Ormus. Right, so I'll go for physics now. That gets me trebuchets. You know, I'm going to send that guy over here now, just to see if that encampment is still there. Okay, so I'm going to send that one over here, and I'll build another one. So I'm going to need five of those to cover all five of my cities. So when I park them in the city, I just leave them as ready to fire. That doesn't really gain me much, because I would still have time to set them up if I needed to. It just means I don't have to take that step. Well, that one is still there, definitely. Unit promotion. Yeah, we'll give him the amphibious promotion. Okay, that's another one of those cleared. Okay, so a pasture there. Then I'll work on turning these into farms. Oh, there's a encampment there. And let's see. Yeah, I'll farm that one. I got a production choice here. You know what? I'm going to make a workboat just so I can improve these resources over there. So a policy. Okay, so we'll go with the free garrison thing. Then I think I'm going to open aesthetics. Because if you complete aesthetics, then you can buy great writers, artists, and musicians in the industrial era. And I didn't go with the belief that allows doing that, so I'm going to have to get there the hard way. $6,900 before a prophet appears and messes up the faith tally. Resume that one. Couple turns for the ironworks in Constantinople. Okay. Send that one up there. Oh, look, I'm down to two road pieces to make this chunk. Apparently the graphics aren't updating particularly well. Right. So I'll build another one of those. Ooh. I think I need to let that one heal for a bit. Okay, ironworks. Heroic epic is 13 turns. I'll build that. Right, that's the catapult. Okay, now it's showing the road. Right, so that's a garden done. I'll build the catapult for there, right there. Those should change to building trebuchets right away here. But, you know, I'll just make sure they change. And I will upgrade these as appropriate. Okay, science-wise, steel would be a good one. That gets the long swordman, I believe. Okay, so I'll set those trebuchets now. Okay, we have a garden there. I'm gonna go for the culture stuff here. Apparently, the Arabs decided a pontoon bridge would be a good idea there. Really, what it does is it makes it easier for me to invade Mecca. Oh, okay, I have that there. I will go ahead and set up for a sea resource improvement. Then I'll get on with farming over there. Right. I need one more of those, if I recall, so I'll build another workboat. Okay, now I can whale on this guy. And now he's done. Oh, maybe I will be going to war with Poland. He's offering me gold for crab. This is good. I will take the deal. Okay, so there's an encampment that I can go after here. Ah, Poland built the Forbidden Palace. Okay. That's a good wonder. It gives you two extra delegates in the World Congress. And we could have had a good shot at it if I'd opened up the right policy tree, but overall, it's not going to make that big of a difference. By the time the end game comes around, by that time you get two delegates per allied city-state, and that means one city-state ally offsets the Forbidden Palace. Apparently, Poland's busy building wonders. So it won't take much to deal with that encampment there. So they'll send that trebuchet to Constantinople. That's just about all of the tiles there that can be improved for Constantinople. There's a couple over here still. Okay. Well, that runs out of wonders to build there. Now I have stacks of horses, so what I'm going to do, what have I got? Where is it? I'm going to build some knights. And I need one more trebuchet. I'm going to park this swordsman outside of the city. Because the trebuchet is going to live there. Well, that cleared up that barbarian. Okay, what have I got here? Banking. Printing press gives me. Yeah, I'm going to go for printing press. Okay, so this is a farm there. No. Yes. 6 gold certainly is useful, so I'll accept that one. You can get along quite nicely by accepting every trade offered, but you can often do better than whatever that first offer trade is. Not always, but often. Okay, so that's my defensive units in my cities. That also goes a long way to the pointiest sticks ranking as well. There's my road to Ormus, which is nice. That was an easy way to get a bunch of influence. Not quite ally. But you know what? I think I'll go ahead and do that. Okay, that one doesn't have to go anywhere, so I'll just park it. Okay, so I've made that road there. I don't need to leave that worker out there. So I'll send him off to do some work. Okay, amphitheater's up. Market should do wonder. Yeah, market will do nice in in there. Right. Build knights here. Well, I can upgrade these swordsmen, so I'm going to do that since the long swordsman is stronger. Do I have enough to upgrade this one? I do. Keeping your units upgraded also helps the pointiest stick rankings. Right. Wonder if that one's still there. Okay, and that's my defensive units installed. What to build here? I'm building up a number of knights here because I want to have some sort of a military arrangement going on. East India Company. No, I'm going to build a settler here. 3 turns. That's blindingly fast for anything in the marathon pace. So I'm going to plant a settler up here. Okay, so that's been cleared. Yeah, there's not much there, so I'll send my my guy home. Okay, well that's a settler out real fast. Now, the question is, well that's definitely a location. So I'll do that. Should give me enough time to build the East India Company. Oh, I should have gone up here and built a quarry. Oh well. Next time around, I guess. So I figure I have a good chance of having to go to war with Poland. So, but all my borders are down the south there, so I'll move most of my troops down that way. I also have plenty of places to park them down that way. Right. Okay. I'm gonna sleep that settler until this finishes. You know? I can build the quarry with that one. Okay, so the Globe Theater's gone. And another bloody great profit. Now, here's the thing. I could build the religious thing there, or I could come over on some useless land over there and build it. So I'll park that guy down there. Okay. So I'll get that wonder out and build, and I'll get another settler out. And I think I'll be able to plant another couple settlers around the snow up there. Yeah, definitely. They won't be high-producing cities, but they will have the sea tiles. So, printing press. Right. I'm gonna go for gunpowder now. Now there's a something, a great musician. And apparently, because I haven't built any opera houses, I don't have anywhere to put great works of music. Let's take a look in the influence chart though. Arabia and Poland are both fairly big culture, and the Celts as well. So I'm actually going to conduct a concert tour. I can't do it in Arabia. I can in Poland, though. So I'll do that. We're voting on World's Fair and banning furs. Banning furs would not inconvenience me any. Though that doesn't mean I want it to happen. And next turn for the wonder here. So I'll have a good chance of making good progress on the World's Fair just because of the production I've got going on in Constantinople. Right, my options here. Another settler. And this one, I'll plant a city. So I think I'll plant the other city here. I don't want to plant it on the stone because I want the quarry. Oh, it's a caravan. What can I build here now? Well, you know, a zoo seems like a good idea. Yeah, we'll keep the open border, so it lets me send my musicians in. Concert tour. And what did that do? So that gets you a significant boost against the civilization where you conduct the tour, but it also gets you a boost against everybody else. Which can make a really big difference late in the game. So that was a granary there. Go for the university there. So I should get the settler out of Constantinople real soon. Okay, so I'll put the settler there. And I'll go for a couple more settlers. Oh, it's voting time. Well, I'm pretty sure the World's Fair will pass, but I don't like banning luxuries, so there we go. We'll see what happens. Oh, the ban on furs passed. So Poland was for it, but not as much for it as for the ban. Okay. So it didn't pass. Let's propose it again. Well, that means I don't have to redirect my production for anything just yet. And I can propose a nice proposal again and make other civilizations happy. Right. And build a zoo there. And a zoo there. I'm doing that for happiness because I'm adding cities. I don't want to go negative. And Casimir happens to like my proposal too. Again. Okay, that's a settler. Right. So if I go coastal here, the stone is in range. And I have hills here which I might be able to mine. So I'll build the city there, and I'll build one more settler, as I think I'll have enough happiness to support that. Good. So I'm coming up on an hour here, so that's getting close to when I'm going to call the part. Yeah, see, this seems like it'd be a good spot, but it really isn't so beneficial as it looks. Anyway, I'll plant the city there. Right. Well, production's decent there. So in 3 turns, I'll have another settler out. This is what you call the late game expansion push. By doing this, I get myself substantially more places where I can construct my religious buildings for tourism. Okay, so let's so I'll get this settler on his way to the build location, and then I'll call it a part, I think. Okay. Wait, nope. The settler. So, I said I was going to settle there. I think there. Yeah, I don't see a percentage in any more settlers there, so I will go ahead and work on catching up the stuff there. The buildings in Constantinople. So I'll just handle this turn here. Oh, this iron can be brought into production as well. Even though it's not in range of a city, you really want to mine that sort of thing just to get the you know, I'll give it another turn or two here. I'll let the settlers get to their destination, I guess. Right. Another couple of turns, a settler will be at his destination there. There might be some percentage in plopping a city in here. It's not great, but it's got the stone, there's iron in range. And sheep, so it might. We'll see. Oh, it's even suggesting a city there. Huh. Well, might as well take a pot shot there while we're at it. And yeah, there's not much going there. I'm going to go for the monument there first, just so that I can expand the borders faster. I end up purchasing buildings there, as you get no production off of the snow tiles, so you only get the two from your city tile. That's gunpowder. That means I can build musket men. Right. So that's a zoo there. I'm going to start building defensive buildings as well. Chemistry gives me the cannon. Red Fort. Yeah, I'll go for metallurgy for the Red Fort. Where's this other settler at? Up there, okay. So I'll give it till that settler gets to his destination, and then right, that's a farm. I've built a university in Constantinople, so I can build a Himeji castle. Yeah, I'll do that. And I'll take a pot shot again. And we're just about to the point where I think next turn I can put that city down. And then I think I'll be able to call it here. Hey, it's suggesting cities there too. I think it's smoking crack, actually. Those don't seem to be particularly good locations. But this hill is in range at least, so I'll plop that down. And I'll start on a monument, and I'll need to get universities and everything out in these three cities. Anyway, I'm going to call that the end of part six here. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. So that's the end of part six. I'll see you back in part seven.